Hello and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop card game coat check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better. Now, what I'm hoping to do for you tonight is let you know about this very cool game. This is a I don't even know what to call it, a trick-taking game, a new card game called Matches. I like to call it a card-burning game. This is from friend of the show, Danny McKinley, and the Everyday Board Games podcast. Big fan of their podcast. I like to call them our sister podcast. So what I'm doing to do today is show you what you get in the box in this game. Now, I do have to thank Danny for giving us a review copy of this. This is published by Thing 12 Games and is currently their new hotness. Haha, get it, right? So I just want to show this game off. We played a game at the Gamma Expo 2024. I really enjoyed it. And I thanks Danny for this copy. But you're welcome because we're telling the world about it right now. So we're all good, right? All good, me, you. All right, let's take a look at what you get in Matches, a modern, traditional style card game. Step one is going to be cutting the shrink on this awesome box, which I don't think you can really see. So here you go. This is one of the better board game boxes I've seen because can you see that? That is your striking strip. And this is here for advertising, but look at this. Burn bright, burn fast, safety matches. It is a giant matchbox, including like the rub bit. And we're going to pull the game out like that. Talk about awesome thematic box. I love it. And I like the fact that this is on there. So like when you're in the store shelf and you pick it up and look at it, you're like, oh, okay, cool. Yeah, it plays 2 to 6 players, ages 8+, 40 minutes a game. One match can change everything. Yeah, it can. This is a very fascinating game. Now, this is not meant to be a rule teach. I am here to show off the components in this game, which look at this, like the matchbox. Then we open it up and you can already see like this bag. You can see this first player token, these stack cards with the burning on top. So we're going to kind of take these all out and look at them one at a time. We'll get to the stuff in the bottom. There is a baggie to hold some of the components, multiple baggies. An advertisement for Thing 12 Games. Check out their other games when you get a chance. Then, what's this? Community Pillar Burns. There's some kind of, I'm not sure what this is. A strip of paper. Oh, yeah. Okay. What? Project Heliopause. Findings on the 1904 flash event. Oh, okay, we have the rules. So we're investigating something. I will admit, I did not see the theming in this one. So the object of the game is to acquire as many fire tokens as you can, which are worth points. And we're going to get to see those in a little bit. I'm not going to teach the game. So you can look at this extremely well laid out set of instructions, lots of examples, lots of showing what's going on, showing how they generally set up a table and how the hands work in this game. This game has some ladder elements, it has some trick-taking elements. It really is something unique, which is why I didn't want to call it a trick-taking game. Again, how to play the game continued. You're looking at maybe 6 pages here. How to burn cards, which is optional. There's some like optional event cards you can throw in. We did not get to try that. And then there is a nice little FAQ here as well. And then credits and special thanks to some of the people involved. Then we have... okay. Something you can discover on your own. Something wonky going on here. I just know the card game aspect. I can't talk to that. First player token. I like it. It's nice. It's big. It's tall. Now let's take a quick look at the cards. Now we'll save those for last. Let's get these open. Already tied. I kind of dig that. Watch me fail at pulling it open. Yep. I love the smoke effect. Like, check that out. This feels like silk. I'm not positive it's silk, but it feels like silk. Okay, more baggies. There you go. Fire tokens. You got orange and red. And I will say they're a little close in color. Like, can you spot the red? It looks like both these are red in my camera, but this is the red. All that is like one's worth 5 and one's worth 1. So they're just the big chunky style aquarium beads, like the bigger ones, not the tiny ascension style, bigger ones. You get a whole bunch of those. I had no reason to keep these in the bag as far as I'm concerned. So I'm just going to dump these in this bag. And fail completely. Oh my God, I've started a fire. Terrible. And no, I am not going to start singing "We Didn't Start the Fire." Deanna is the Billy Joel fan and karaoke fanatic. We're going to tie that back up. Put this off to the side and get back to those cards. Everything's kind of messy here. This thing's creeping me out. Here, I'm going to put it right there. There, now it won't. Okay, cards. Okay. These are the special cards. Did I take one too many? Yes. I love the texture of these. They're linen finish. See, Danny gave me a sleeved copy when I played. Oh, there's even UV coating on that. That's nice. See, I played with the sleeve copy, and this is way nicer than the sleeve copy. So these are those special cards, optional rules that change some of the rules. Like a third degree urn, one player of your choice discards all their pairs played this round. There's some like nasty things you can play on other players. Copy the effect of a previously played card and so on. These are the burn cards. Like, burn, I got you, burn, right? Adds a little more PvP to it, a little stabby in the back. And then we have the cards. So these are the Raging Fire cards you play. And then the rest are these really nice looking, looks like kind of standard playing cards. They've got it underneath. They all have the same flame token, but I like that they still fold out. And I actually like that if you notice, the higher the number, the more burnt the card is. So two is two matches. And then you have threes or three matches, fours, fives, and so on, all the way up to 10. And see how the 9's even more burned and the 10's even more burned. I really like that effect. I thought it was very cool. So I can't remember. It's like 4 of each card. Here, let's find out. 3, 4, 5. 5 of each card. 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5 of each card, but then there's 10 ones, I think it is. Yeah, looks right. Oh, I'm loving. Listen to this. They just have a good sound. And I'm not being like super excited because I know Danny and Danny's awesome. I really was impressed by this game when I got to try it out. And I really do love the way these cards look. I said that the little subtle things like how the cards get more burnt. So there you go. That's what you get in matches. I would love you to teach you how to play, but that's not what I'm here to do today. There we go. Slide it back into the matchbox. Ta-da. Matches. Thing 12 games. All right. There you get first look at matches. I got to say, like, you can tell I'm hyped about this, right? I am really looking forward to playing this. I'm bringing this out to local public play events. We are big fans of trick-taking games, traditional card games. The way I like to describe this game is someone took the Hoyle Book of Games and lit it on fire. So it's a very unique, very different, but very traditional feeling. Like, it feels like you're playing a traditional card game while still being new and unique and very thematic. I do dig this game. Looking forward to playing it more. Thank you for joining me for the unboxing of Matches from Thing 12 Games. Now, when I do actually get this played, I will be talking about it on our Bellhop's Tabletop segment of the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which we record live Wednesday nights on Twitch, twitch.tv/tabletopbellhop. We try to go live every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern. Yeah, we take a couple weeks off during the year now and then when we go to cons or when things come up, like my wife's out of town. That's what happened this past Wednesday. But we try to go live every Wednesday, and I would love to see you there in the lobby, our chat room on Twitch. And you can hear me talk about games like Matches and all those games you see behind me. So thank you for joining me. Good day and game on.